Hey guys, so this video is going to focus on how to find missing angles just using different relationships that we know about angles, such as vertical angles and supplementary angles. So here we have a particular situation where we have a few different lines cutting through, and we need to try and figure out how to find those missing angles. So we're trying to find angle X, angle Y, and angle Z. So I'm going to go ahead and I am going to start with finding angle X. So my thinking process when it comes to angle X is that when I look close to angle X here, I see that angle X is up against this straight line. It goes straight up and down here. And what I know about a straight line is that any straight line or any straight angle is equal to 180 degrees. So if I take this straight line, I know that any angles within this straight angle here have to add up to 180 degrees. So that means that this little angle X along with this angle of 139, those have to make up 180 degrees because those are all of the angles within this straight angle. So that essentially means that that 139 plus the X that I have to equal 180 degrees. So if I take the 180 degrees and I subtract the 139 from it, it should give me this little piece, my little X there. It should give me what that is equal to. So if I just take this 180 and I subtract 139 from it, well, let's see, 180 minus 139 is 41. What that tells me is that angle X is 41 degrees. And I was able to do that just by using definition of a straight angle. So 139 plus that 41 angle of an X does add up to 180 degrees, which does make up a straight angle there. So then I'm going to work on finding angle Z next. So I'm going to use angle Z because after I find angle X, I see that angle Z is clear across angle X. Notice that they're like opposite of each other there. And what I know about lines in that relationship is that those are vertical lines. Keep in mind that vertical lines vertical angles are angles that are directly opposite from each other when two different lines intersect. All right, so if I take this straight line here and then this other straight line that cuts through there, those are two lines that intersect. So therefore, the angles opposite of those are vertical angles. So that means that angle X is vertical angles with angle Z. And what I know about vertical angles is that vertical angles are congruent. They are exactly the same thing. So if angle X is 41 degrees, that tells me that angle Z is 41 degrees by using the definition of vertical angles. All right, so now we need to focus on finding angle Y. So what I'm going to do to find angle Y is I'm going to use this straight line still that's right there up and down, and I'm going to use the opposite side of it. I'm going to use the same concept of a straight angle totaling 180 degrees, but now I'm looking at the right side. And if I'm looking at the right side, that means angle Z plus angle Y plus that 49 have to equal 180 degrees. So I have three separate angles here inside this straight angle, and all three of these have to add up to 180 degrees. So that means that angle Z, which is 41 degrees, plus angle Y, which we don't know yet, plus that 49 over here that they already gave us. So all three of these has to equal 180 degrees. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add up the 41 plus the 49. So let's see, if I add those together, I get 90 degrees there. So 41 plus 49 is 90 degrees. So all I have to do is then take that 180 minus those 90 degrees. So I'm going to subtract the 90 degrees. And what I get is that angle Y is 90 degrees. So we're taking the 180 and we're subtracting the 49 that we know. We're subtracting the Z that we know. And it's going to leave us with that missing piece of the Y. So we now know that angle Y is a total of 90 degrees. So by using supplementary angles and by using vertical angles, we are able to fill in the missing pieces. Otherwise, that is it for this video.